London's Spun Candy Sweet Workshop would give Willy Wonka a run for his golden ticket. Their master candy makers turn sugar into edible art.
Sugar candy was invented 2,000 years ago in India when they worked out how to get sugar crystals from sugar cane. And the word itself comes from old ancient Sanskrit, sarkara kanda, where sarkara means sugar and kanda actually means lump of. So candy really means just lump of.
Today, we've challenged Pavel Radzikowski and Agata Jaskowska to weave a one-off candy.
It's definitely a bit more challenging to make something that you've never done before.
The writing in rock candy is beyond the capability of almost any machine. So every letter is hand-delivered by a master. Whether it's the traditional stick of rock or its bite-sized candy offspring, the starting point for all rock candy is sugar, which is added to water and brought to the boil. The candy needs to be flexible so it can be shaped. This mix will be rock hard as soon as it cools. The solution is a measure of glucose syrup, which gives the candy an elastic texture, so it can be stretched and worked. Pavel leaves the bucket in so the glucose slowly dissolves in the boiling sugar. Don't worry, he takes it out before anyone eats it. The sugar solution is sweet but tasteless, so Agata gives this batch a dash of natural apple flavouring. Then Pavel turns his attention to texture. The 150-degree candy is sticky, really sticky.
Have you ever wondered why is sugar sticky? When it gets wet, the water breaks the sugar molecules apart, leaving hydrogen. And this hydrogen acts like a glue to bond more sugar molecules to anything else that they touch.
Pavel solves his sticky situation by covering his worktop with edible beeswax. This will stop the candy sticking to the marble surface.
This is our huge, thick marble table, which will cool down our candy. It absorbs the heat from the candy.
The hot candy may taste amazing, but it's lacking its iconic bright colours. A rainbow of food dyes deals with that, but it's not as simple as splashing them in. Rock candy is famous for having a message running right through it. So as the molten candy cools, it's dyed in sections. Black for lettering, red and blue for the outside.
One last ingredient is our citric acid.
The sugar is cooling too fast. If it starts to crystallize, Pavel won't be able to work it. A little edible citric acid breaks the large sucrose molecules down into smaller glucose and fructose molecules, slowing crystallization. The colours are divided, to be worked on separately and carefully. In places, the candy is still 130 degrees Celsius, which could cause serious burns.
The edges of the candy are very cold, but here, in the middle, is still liquid. It's like lava.
The candy is still too tough to chew. So in keeping with the handmade method, Agata and Pavel use muscle power and a process called pulling.
We have to hang the candy on a hook and start stretching it.
Stretching and working the candy traps thousands of air bubbles, making it lighter and chewier. It's also cooling and developing minute, light reflective crystals that give the sugar its satin sheen.
We love sugar, but nowhere near as much as in the USA. The average American eats 3/4 of their body weight in sugar every year. That's like 30 cubes of sugar a day.
The next challenge is to create the words that will run right through the rock candy. Hand-making tiny letters would be impossible, so Pavel makes huge ones instead, while Agata prepares the white filling to go between them. The clock is ticking. Every second, the candy becomes harder to work.
That's our enemy, the temperature. And over time, candy slowly getting colder and colder, and that's what makes it a bit more difficult.
To buy time, they work on a table preheated to 70 degrees.
So first, I'll have to build white spaces and just wrap them with black candy. So that's our H.
Pavel is a master of the candy alphabet, but we've thrown him a curveball.
I've never done a question mark before, so let's try it. It has to be done perfectly, otherwise the whole batch will go in a bin. It looks a bit weird now, but once it's combined with the other words, it should be fine.
Now to turn letters into words. Needless to say, spelling mistakes will not be tolerated. So the design is proofread three times before the white filling is used to hold it all together. As it cools, it starts to set. But if it doesn't set as a cylinder, the whole batch will be ruined. So Agata constantly rolls the candy to retain its shape. Layers of colour, four red, four blue, are carefully cut and wrapped around the candy.
So that's our huge piece of candy now. So it's very heavy, as you can tell.
The lump weighs almost 16 kilograms, far too big to eat. It needs to be thin sticks with words through each one. So they stretch it by hand until the letters shrink from 3 centimeters tall to just 1 millimeter. Creating up to 40 sticks of rock in the process. Next stop, the chopping block, where the sticks are sliced into mouth-watering, bite-sized delights. Complete with a perfect question mark.